Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
Lord, God, well, tonight, we just ask for your guidance. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So stand for this.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Bill. This time, call the meeting to order. I'd like to welcome all of you here to the first December meeting of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners. Good to see a great crowd, and we have a lot of exciting stuff going on tonight. There were no folks that signed up for the public comment section, so item number three is any commissioner's responses to the public comment or any other comment that anyone would like to make at this time. Are there any comments from the board?
I would like to make a comment. I want Eddie Boswell to know that he's been one of the easiest people to work with in the last 4 years, and he deserves a round of applause.
Thank you, Bill. He does indeed. As a matter of fact, we've got an item on the agenda just for him coming up very, very shortly. Any other comments at this time? If not, commissioners, if you'll take a minute and review the agenda, which would include the consent agenda. The agenda is fairly straightforward this evening. The items on the consent agenda mostly have to do with appointments to a couple of boards. Mr. Honeycutt, are there any changes to the agenda as we have it in front of us?
There is one change. We recently received a grant from the North Carolina Housing and Finance, and in front of you is a project ordinance for $160,000, which would cover that grant cost. There is no local match with that. It's just to put the grant money into a capital project budget.
So it is a budget item then?
Yes, sir. And I was going to do that under my update, if that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine. Is that all right with everyone?
Sure.
Board members, Craig, I'm sorry, are there any other changes?
No, additions? Sir. No, sir.
Board members, any comment on the agenda other than what Craig just said? Including the consent agenda then, we'll entertain a motion for approval. Thank you, Tim.
Second.
Is there a second? Eddie? Thank you. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The agenda is approved, including the consent agenda. Now I'd like to turn the meeting over to Brian Haygood for a very, very special presentation. Brian, welcome.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good evening, commissioners. Here this evening to recognize Central Communications employee Pam Williams for outstanding service. Pam is with us. I'd like to ask her to come up and join me here at the podium. Pam has members of her family here and several folks from CCOM as well. Come on, Pam. Pam is a senior 911 telecommunicator with CCOM. She has over 9 years of experience with CCOM, has some law enforcement experience also. And on Monday morning, November 26th, about 5:40 a.m., she received a call from a father who was in the process of helping his wife give birth to a baby. The caller indicated to Pam that the birth was imminent, the baby was on the way. Pam maintained her bearing and reacted quickly and did a fantastic job walking that dad and mom through the birthing of their baby using emergency medical dispatch protocols. She helped deliver a baby boy.
Yes.
So she just did a fantastic job. We want to recognize her here this evening. We have an excerpt of the call. So if you bear with us for a moment, I'd like to play a little bit of that so you can get a real appreciation for the job that Pam did. So,
Kenny. Okay. All right. As the baby delivers, support the baby's head and the shoulders and hold the hips and the legs firmly, okay? But just let me know when the head is out. Did they say how far they're out? I've got somebody within 3 miles of you, okay?
All right,
don't
you hurry up.
All right, the head is out.
Okay. All right,
are you going to go? Okay. Have her push hard to get the baby out. Is there anything wrapped around the baby's neck?
I got it out.
You got the baby out?
I got it out.
Okay, so the baby is out. Time is 6:02. All right, sir, is there anything wrapped around the baby's neck?
No, ma'am.
Okay, is the baby crying or breathing yet?
Yeah, he's crying
and breathing. All right, he's crying and breathing. Time of birth is 6:02. All right, sir, here's what I need you to do. Try and get somebody in there to you. Gently wipe out the baby's mouth and nose.
All right.
Okay, dry the baby off with a clean towel.
All right,
then wrap the baby in a clean, dry towel. Cover the baby's head and not the face.
Well, on behalf of Alamance County, we just really want to thank Pam for a fantastic job. That's a small excerpt of a 20-plus minute call of her using her expertise as a CECOM telecommunicator. Just a fantastic job, Pam.
And Brian, so if I can add on behalf of the board and entire citizen group of Alamance County, we do have a certificate that I'd just like to read to you. Craig and Brian put this together, presented to Pam Williams, telecommunicator, in recognition of the commitment and compassion that you have shown to the welfare of citizens of Alamance County. Your sense of community responsibility, dedication, and hard work is a value to Alamance County. The Alamance County Board of Commissioners would like to thank you for being an outstanding employee presented this third day of December 2012.
So
and that was a very nice article in the paper, Chris, your folks did, to tell that story as well. As Bill Lashley indicated, this is Eddie Boswell's last night as county commissioner, at least for a while, and appreciate Bill's comments. All of you served with Eddie a lot longer than I did. Would just ask if anyone else has any comments about Eddie leaving.
Well, Eddie has done a great job. He really has, and I'm going to miss him. I can tell you that. So now we don't know who we're going to put on that school board either. Not me. Okay. I told Tom the other day I wanted to keep all my boards. He said, "You can have all you want, Linda." I said, "I got all I want."
Well, I'll just add, and I can speak to the school board part, Eddie did volunteer and step up to the plate. I think when Dan left to go to Raleigh, Eddie became the school board liaison and would hear grueling testimony of what was going on at the central office and was very, very loyal in his attendance there. And that was a very important function that you served, in addition to working here, obviously, with this board and all the different committees and things, so we are very much going to miss you.
Well, thank you. It's been my pleasure to serve on this board, and it's people like Ms. Williams there that made it a pleasure, because this county is very blessed to have a lot of good people that work right here in this county, and they make our job a lot easier.
That's so true.
And I just want to thank them. I want to thank the rest of the commissioners for helping me, you know, because it was all new to me when I came on this board, and it's been a pleasure serving, and I've enjoyed it. And actually, I've been asked to serve on the Alamance Partnership, one of the boards I was sitting on. So I do plan on staying active with some other things.
Would you like to be an ad hoc liaison to the school board?
I will pass on
that. Well, Eddie, if you would, come here and stand. We do have a recognition, a plaque for you. Actually, we have two things. Am I allowed to open this one?
Yes.
Okay. I thought this was kind of cool. I think we should all get one. This is a coaster, Alamance County, North Carolina, with our official seal that you can have and put where you will. But this is a plaque honoring Eddie that I would like to read, and then we can hold it up together. The Alamance County Board of Commissioners expresses sincere appreciation to Eddie Boswell for his unselfish devotion of time, energy, and ability to the people of Alamance County by serving as Alamance County Commissioner from December 1st, 2008 December 3rd, 2012, presented this day, the third day of December 2012. So, let me give that to you.
And my pleasure.
Thomas, I'm not sure that's his. That may be property that we need to recycle.
He's fine. No, he's fine.
Yeah, I'm kidding. But here, Eddie, I do want to give you the box that the coaster came in. Thomas. Okay. At this time, we are going to have the administration of the oaths of office to folks that were elected in the recent election. We're going to start with the Soil and Water Conservation District Supervisors, and I see David Spruill here, and the other, and this is an education for me and all of us, I guess. The Soil and Water, David knows this, but some people are elected and some people are appointed, and David was elected during the past election. There's also an appointee who is not with us tonight. So at this time, we would like to recognize and honor David Spruill and have Judge Katie Overby, who's kind enough to be with us, administer the oath to David Spruill. So David, if you'll come forward.
I state your name.
David Michael Spruill.
Do solemnly swear that I will support and maintain the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina, not inconsistent therewith, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of my office as Alamance County Soil and Water Conservation District Supervisor, so help me God.
I do.
I state your name.
David Michael Spruill.
Do solemnly and sincerely swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States, that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the state of North Carolina and to the constitutional powers and authorities which are or may be established for the government thereof, and that I will endeavor to support, maintain, and defend the Constitution of said state, not inconsistent with the Constitution of the United States, to the best of my knowledge and ability, so help me God.
I do.
I state your name.
David Michael Spruill.
Do you swear that I will well and truly execute the duties of the Office of Alamance County Soil and Water Conservation District Supervisor according to the best of my skill and ability, according to law, so help me God.
I do.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
David, congratulations to you. Next, we will have the administration of the oath to Commissioner Linda Massey, recently reelected, and that oath will be administered by the Honorable Judge Jim Robertson. Judge, welcome.
Thank you. As Commissioner Massey's coming up, we'd want to address the board briefly just to say that it's an honor for we three judges to get an opportunity and an invitation swearing public servants. We're particularly excited about swearing in County Commissioners because we have a long history of a good relationship, working relationship with our County Commissioners. It's appreciated. We appreciate it very much. We also appreciate your willingness to step out and for future service, for past service, for all you've done for Alamance County. It's a thankless job for which we thank you.
Thank you, Judge.
Now, I get a great privilege of swearing in Commissioner Massey. I state your name.
Linda Massey.
Do solemnly swear that I will support and maintain the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina, not inconsistent therewith, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of my office as County Commissioner for the County of Alamance, so help me God, and so say I do.
I do.
And I state your name.
Linda Massey.
Do swear that I will well and truly execute the duties of my office of County Commissioner for the County of Alamance according to the best of my skill and ability, according to law, so help me God, so say I do.
I do.
Commissioner, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, I think I'm next on the agenda, and I'm honored to have the Honorable Judge Tom Lambeth here. I would like to say that every time I've been sworn in, both on the school board, after Tom became judge, and here, Tom's been kind enough to help me, and I appreciate you being here again.
Thank you very much. Janet, you want to come join him? I want to echo what Judge Robertson just said. We do very much appreciate the working relationship with the whole board, historically and currently. And Tom, just a personal privilege note here, I really appreciate you asking me. We go way back and, of course, serve faithfully together on the school board for several years, and it's always an honor to be here to swear you in. So yeah, I'll let your lovely wife hold that, and if you will put your left hand on the Bible and raise your right. I state your name.
Tom Manning.
Do solemnly swear that I will support and maintain the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina, not inconsistent therewith, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of my office as County Commissioner for the County of Alamance. So help me God.
I do.
I state your name.
Tom Manning.
Do swear that I will well and truly execute the duties of the office of County Commissioner for the County of Alamance, according to the best of my skill and ability, according to law, so help me God.
I do.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Now it's my pleasure to welcome our newest commissioner, David I. Smith, come forward, and he will be administered the oath by Judge Katie Overby.
Folks, I have nothing against these gentlemen here, but I've heard a beautiful judge.
I think you made a great choice.
Thank you. Place your left hand on the Bible, raise your right hand. I state your name.
David I. Smith.
Do solemnly swear that I will support and maintain the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina, not inconsistent therewith, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of my office as County Commissioner for the County of Alamance, so help me God.
I do.
I state your name.
David I. Smith.
Do swear that I will well and truly execute the duties of the office of County Commissioner for the County of Alamance according to the best of my skill and ability, according to law, so help me God.
I do.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Judge.
Thank you.
David.
Do we have his, oh, look at this. We have his nameplate.
How about that? Mm-hmm. Wow. This lady is prepared.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Right. I get
yes.
paid now.
Now you got to wait a while for that. You got to work.
David, welcome. And again, I just want to reiterate for the three judges to take your time and to be with us tonight. It means a lot to all of us. Thank you. Thank you. And feel free to stay for the remaining 4.5 hours of the meeting, or you're free to leave.
I won't volunteer for the school board.
Now, we got him on the board. We got Judge Jim.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Judge.
I guess now at this time, we will accept nominations for the election of the board chair. Is there a nomination?
I would like to nominate Tom Manning, chair.
Second.
There's a nomination by Commissioner Lashley and a second by Commissioner Sutton. Any other nominations? Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Your new chair.
Thank you, Craig. Bill, thank you for the nomination. Board, thank you for the support that you've placed in me. And now together, again, we continue to move forward and tackle the issues at hand. And the next issue at hand is the election of vice chair. And that's item number 10. And I would like to make the nomination that Bill Lashley continued to serve in that position as vice chair.
Second.
Thank you, Tim. Is there any discussion or other nominations? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
We have the nicest elections of any board in the state.
We do.
I don't have any question about it.
We do. We do. Well, I appreciate everybody, like I said, working together and being able to talk to each other and talk about what we have and what's important for Alamance County. Remarks from the newly elected chairman, vice chairman, and county commissioners. The only thing I have, I received a couple of letters. Brian, I'm not sure that you've announced this, but we did get $75,000 from the state, and Governor Perdue sent this on the sponsorship of the Cedar Rock Park Enhancement Project.
Yes, sir.
I don't want to put you on the spot, but can you comment on that?
I can. We applied for funding from the Water Resources Grant. We applied for $75,000 total. This is for the project to acquire the acreage, approximately 80 acres, in front of Cedar Rock Park. And out of that $75,000, $50,000 can be used toward acquisition. The other $25,000, if the county gets purchases the property, can be used toward development. And we'll be coming to you in January with what we hope will be the final grant application, an RTP grant for the balance of the funding. And I have to say, the department staff have just made it their mission to try to do this with, as keeping the county's expense to a minimum, and they've done a fantastic job. So this is one of those that have come to fruition.
And as you had predicted and promised, going through this process wouldn't involve any direct county funding. You've done it all through piecing grants together.
That's been the goal. That's been the goal.
So congratulations.
We have one more effort. So.
Thank you. The other letter that I received was from John Moon. John wanted the board to know that he has been elected by Cardinal Innovations. Cardinal Innovations is the name of the entity that formerly was PBH, Piedmont Behavioral Health. We had approved several people to be considered for that board, and John has been selected under their new board structure to represent this area, Alamance County and Caswell County. Basically, the former LME that we had here. I've worked with John in different occasions over the years, and I think he'll be a good representative for us and a good liaison. So that's a matter of information. That's the other piece of news that I had. Comments from the vice chair. That would be you.
I want the citizens of Alamance County to know that I have appreciated serving on this board for 16 years. I look forward to serving two more years. It's been a pleasure to serve all the citizens of Alamance County.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you. Any other comments? New commissioner initiation?
Is this the time that we say something if we want to say?
If you would like to, but you're under no obligation to.
Oh, I have a lot to say. I want to thank everybody for being here. Of course, my two sisters and a lot of my friends left. They don't care too much about the functions of our board. But I'm glad to be here. It's been 4 years since I left here, as a matter of fact, and it's good to be back. I have a couple of issues I'd like to bring before the board for consideration. Is this the time to do that?
Sure.
And it's just for consideration. So I've been thinking about it. And one of the reasons that I decided to run for county commissioner was financial, in that I thought the county needed a new direction or needed some new direction in financial matters. We have a fiscal problem. Of course, a lot of people have, a lot of companies have. So I've been thinking, and some of you may have seen it in the newspapers, an idea that I came up with that I would like for the board to consider. There's no action to be taken, certainly wouldn't consider any. But I'd like for you to consider it in the vein of trying to solve problems that we have, and I feel like that's what I would like to do on this board, is to help solve problems. I don't blame anybody for anything. I just want to see if we can run good government, which we've done in the past, and I think we'll continue doing. The main thing is, I told you I had a plan. I just want to bring this plan up to you, board members. And that is to request the local legislators to introduce a local bill in the legislature to raise the sales tax in Alamance County 1 cent. I know nobody wants to raise taxes. I certainly don't want to raise taxes. And that is for a two-year period only. But in conjunction with that, the commissioners would lower the property tax rate at least 5 cents. I think the rate now is 52, so it would be lowered to what, 47, 48, Tim? I can't figure too much in my head. And that cut in the property tax for that period of time of 5 cents is almost a 10% cut. Taxes that are collected with that 1 cent increase in sales tax, all of the taxes over and above what it takes to cover that 5% cut in property taxes would be put in the fund balance. This is not money to be raised to spend. It is put money in the fund balance and get our fund balance back in good, healthy shape. And I think, I thought that the 1 cent would raise about $10 to $12 million a year. I heard or read somewhere that it may raise $15 million a year, which is fine. It may raise $15 million a year. That means we might could cut the property tax more than 5 cents, and maybe not have to do the tax but one time, 1 year program. So it's just something that everything is flexible. Everything is can be changed. Everything is negotiable. In the 2 years, the fund balance, if we can raise $10 to $12 million, I prefer a conservative approach to estimating fund balances. In the 2 years, if we could get that amount of money, we should be able to get the undesignated fund balance up $25-30 million, which I think would be a good, healthy fund balance for us, and we would be ready for any emergency or anything that comes up, like the economic development project that seems to be on the table. I don't know much about it because I haven't been apprised of it yet, and I'm sure I will be. Now, I also have been accused of using smoke and mirrors, because if the 1 cent brings in $15 million rather than $10 or $12 million, that it doesn't mean that we're going to spend any money. We're just going to put that into fund balance too and see what can be done. The advantage is you get a lower property tax, which gives our homeowners a tax break. It helps our local businesses, which need tax breaks at this time, and hopefully with these tax breaks they're going to spend more money in the county and help us to recover. It shows economic development projects that we do have a strong, very healthy government, and that we're interested in good fiscal actions in our county, and we want companies to come in who are stable and will be an asset to our county. Now, if you don't like this plan, come in with a plan, or you folks out in the audience, or folks out in the county, come in with a plan if you have the idea. I like ideas. I'm not wed to anything particularly except building up the fund balance. So I hope that we can get something going, and I think during the budget session that'll be coming up in the next month or so, we can talk about it again. But if you would think about it, hopefully also during the budget sessions, we are going to be able to do some cutting of expenses in the county, and see if we can't protect our low property tax and keep it low. I have one other minor, or shorter one, folks, and Mr. Chairman, I hope you'll give me just a minute. The employees of the county haven't had a raise in 4 years because of our economic problems here in Alamance County, and we still have those problems, there's no doubt about it. They haven't had any raises. Their pay has actually been cut some. The sheriff has some problems with keeping people because they're going to Guilford County and Orange County, where they can make $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 more a year than they can make in Alamance County. We are spending a lot of money training these folks, and then another county picks them up. You can't blame our employees because they have families and they need to do as well as they possibly can. But it's a money-losing proposition for Alamance County. So, you know, our employees, we need to show them that we appreciate our employees and that we need them, and we know they do a good job. I'm asking the board to consider a $500 bonus, a one-time bonus. Hopefully it can be done this month. I would suggest that the county manager and the finance officer get together and see if they can find it in the present budget. If they can't, I have a little experience in finding money in budgets. Be glad to help them out. But I would like, if we could, get that done. So, in the next few months, I'm going to enjoy working with all of you. I know all of you very well. I worked for two of you for 12 years. Worked for Linda 1 month. And really? Tom, you're the new one. So I appreciate your consideration and your thoughts on this, and would love to hear back from you.
Thank you, David.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I'd like to comment, ask a question now, if you don't mind. I read in the paper your plan, and you made reference that you were going to cut taxes, or if it was approved, you'd cut taxes, and that the sales tax would only be for 2 years. You know, our budget's a continuous budget, and what would you do after 2 years with the lack of income that the current
tax? Where the 5 cents has been cut?
Yeah.
Well, that's totally negotiable, but my idea is you're going to have to go back to the 5 cents. But if during that two-year period, you can cut enough spending down, you may not have to go back the full 5 years. I mean, all 5 cents.
So you're saying cut it and raise it back?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's my idea, Tim. If you have a different idea, please come vote.
Well, I wouldn't support that, to be honest with you. Not that. Methodology, if that's the right word. And have you had any different response from our legislators on this? I understand that two out of three weren't very favorable of going to Raleigh with this.
One of them is trying to reach me. So I don't know about the others. I haven't talked to any of them. I said no. And you're right. They have to present it to the legislature as a local bill. But we've got to do something, and if somebody can come up with a better idea, fine, let's do it. But we can't sit around, I don't think, expecting manna from heaven to come down and give us some money to build our fund balance back up. So action, some kind of action, any kind of action.
And I understand the raises, if we've got roughly 1,000 employees, right, full-time?
Right.
Around 900 now.
900 even? Okay, and $500 bonus, that would be about $500,000. And I'm not sure where we'd find that in
fund balance. I can find it.
Well, yeah, if you just take it, yeah. No offense, I just want to ask you those questions. That was the first question I saw, was where you said cut taxes 5 cents, and then for 2 years, I thought, well, what are we going to do after 2 years? So you've answered that.
Well, you can cut them 6 cents,
yeah.
7 cents, whatever you come up with.
Craig, you'll give us kind of an interim update through what, November or so?
Right, and at our next meeting, we'll also have the final audit report. So, and we have added money back, you know, to fund balance.
So we'll hear the full report on
the full report will be at our next meeting. But there are some areas where we've had some savings this year. One is the 401k Commissioner Lashley asked us to look at. So there's some savings there that have not been expended, but if the board so directs us, we will be glad to sit down and come up with options if that's something you would like to see us do.
Okay, any other comments? Next item is item number 12. Craig, approval of the bonds for the public officials. We've got a list for the sheriff and for our register of deeds and for who else? There's
Tax collector, yeah. Sheriff, finance officer, and register of deeds. These are the statutory requirements for public officials' bonds, and we submit it to you for your approval.
And those amounts are listed on the agenda, but
yes,
for
sir.
Folks that don't have the agenda, let's go ahead and recite those, please.
For Gerald York, $50,000 as tax collector. Amy Weaver, $100,000 as finance officer. Hugh Webster, $50,000 as register of deeds. And Sheriff Johnson, $50,000. And these are the statutory requirements that we are meeting.
And do any of these represent a change from the level where they've been?
No, sir.
Okay. And you need a motion?
Yes, sir.
To approve. Is there a motion to approve these bonds? Thank you, Bill. Is there a second? Thank you, Linda. Any discussion or questions about the amount of the bonds? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you, Craig. And we do have one budget amendment, and this is separate from the budget ordinance that you mentioned. This is a budget amendment from the Sheriff's Department.
Yes, sir.
Sheriff Johnson, good evening.
Good evening, Commissioners. Good to be here tonight. Good to see y'all ready to go to work. I'm asking tonight that we get what is called the State Criminal Alien Assistance Program monies that we hold on state inmates that are aliens, criminal aliens here. We get paid by the state, and the amount of funds this year is $28,106, and I'm asking that that be put into account 4320-601. And out of that $28,106, we have to pay Robert Siegel, a company who comes in and processes these fees for us, $4,215.90. And I'm asking that money, once transferred into 432601, that $4,215.90 be transferred from that fund into 432190. Any questions?
Questions about the grant?
I'll make the motion.
Thank you, Bill. There's a motion. Is there a second? Thank you, Linda. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
And before I turn it over to Craig, I just want to remind the group up here that Tori's going to get mad at me if I don't say when we adjourn here in a few minutes, picture time. So don't leave because we're going to get a new picture, a new group picture.
I wonder why she brought her bullwhip.
Okay. Craig.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chairman. With respect to the grant project budget ordinance that you have in front of you, we recently received a $160,000 grant for single-family rehab housing from the North Carolina Housing and Finance Institute, and this is the project budget ordinance for your consideration. Again, no local dollars being used. And if approved by the board, we will start taking applications for rehab beginning December 7th, and we'll make sure that we advertise this on the web. But I apologize not being in your agenda packet. We just received it.
And that was placed in front of each
yes,
commissioner. David, did you get a copy of that?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, no. It's over there. Okay.
Is this it?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Any questions for the county manager on the single-family rehabilitation grant project budget ordinance? There are no questions. Is there a motion for approval or, I guess, ratification of this ordinance?
I'll make that motion.
Thank you, Linda. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you, David. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
And I do have three dates that I would like to make sure you have on your calendar. One is this Wednesday, December 5th at 7:30 is the public officials breakfast at Alamance Community College. That's their annual breakfast. And that, again, that'll begin at 7:30. December 14th will be the employee Christmas luncheon. And that will be at Graham Rec. And that will be from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. And then on December 18th, we do have the Employee Service Award breakfast that will be held in this room at 9 a.m. And that is all I have.
Thank you, Craig.
Thank you.
Anything else? Anything else to come before the board? If not, we stand adjourned. Picture time, though, guys.
Next.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the Commissioners website, where you can learn about our Commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.